Hey, what is up, everyone? Welcome to Unchallenged Gaming. I'm your host, Unchallenged. In this video, this will be the third part of our three-part series. Now, in this third part video, we're going to go ahead and show you guys how to install shaders for your Minecraft 1.19 gameplay. And we're going to go ahead and showcase what this world looks like with shaders. My favorite shaders are obviously complimentary, so I will have this linked in the description below. So definitely go check it out. Okay, so let's go ahead and jump into the installation process. Okay, and with that said, if you guys are brand new here to the channel, go down below, hit the red button to subscribe, make it gray, hit the bell to be notified every time we release a brand new video. And of course, give this video a thumbs up, make it blue. We go live here on the channel every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. So if you guys are interested in Minecraft related content, we play hardcore survival, normal survival, SMP style stuff. Our servers are completely public, so definitely check us out, subscribe, and follow along. So what we're going to be doing here is installing shaders, and our frame rate will drop while we're running shaders, but still we will have better than normal experience. So right now we have 160 to 210 frames per second while traveling in this world. Let's go ahead and exit out of here once again. Completely close out of your Minecraft world. Log out and close out of the game. And we're going to head over to irisshaders.net. So this will be a link down in the description below or in the pinned comment down below this video. If it is not there, go ahead and drop me a comment. Said, hey, Unchallenged, you forgot to put the pinned comment to the website. Go ahead and drop it there. I appreciate that. Okay, so once you're on the website here, it'll appear just like this. Iris Shaders, you'll have the option to download Iris. This is Iris, a lens into the new era of Minecraft graphics. You're gonna wanna select download now. Now, the Iris installer, what this installer does, it basically goes through and installs multiple things. The Iris installer is its installer, right? So it's similar to the Fabric installer. This is just gonna be downloaded not to your mods folder, as we've previously did with the API and the Sodium mod. This is an installer overall, which installs things on, such as the install of the Iris, and it also places Sodium within your mods folder for you if you haven't done that, which we did in step two, and it does a few other things on your computer. So essentially here, what you're wanting to do is go ahead and select download the universal jar, and this is going to be installer. So I'm gonna go ahead and install this on my desktop downloads right next to my Fabric installer. I'm going to go ahead and select save right here, and it's going to go ahead and download. If you guys are on Firefox, you may have it downloaded into your downloads folder. I'm using Chrome Brave client here, sort of thing. So it's installed and I can see it right on the bottom left hand corner. I'm going to go ahead and select it here to pull up my installer right away. Now, again, make sure your Minecraft client, your Minecraft launcher is closed. And what you're going to want to do here is there's no thing to change here. It's Iris and Sodium. You're installing it for your game version 1.19. You're installing it in the .minecraft directory and install it as a Fabric mod. For me, if you check this box, Iris will be installed to your mods. Let's go ahead and read that sign real quick. To your mods folder, allowing you to use Iris with other Fabric mods. So I would always recommend selecting that box and installing. If you have any sort of error here, make sure that your Minecraft launcher, your Minecraft game is closed. If you don't have it closed, it will say here that it's using another instance and it won't allow you to install. And for me, it's an existing mods folder was already found with the game directory. Do you want to update the install Iris? I already had it all kind of going, so of course it's going to be there. I'm just going to go ahead and select yes. So you guys probably won't have that option because you guys don't have the Iris installer and all that stuff already installed, but it doesn't make any difference for me because it just installs the same stuff that I already had installed, right? So there we go. We have downloaded and installed Iris. We can go ahead now and close out of this and go on to the next step, which is loading up our launcher once again. Now, we can verify that the Iris did install by heading over to your Fabric loader. I doubled it up in accident. It's okay. I can go ahead and delete one of those. And we still have our Fabric loader. They were the exact same loaders there. Now, I can check my mods really quickly by selecting my folder icon and going into my folder. And we can see here we have the Fabric API, which we loaded in step one video. We have the Sodium mod, which we loaded in our step two video of how to install Sodium, basically double our frame rate when you're playing without resource packs, not without resource packs, but without shaders. And now we downloaded the Iris mod, and this is what allows you to install shader packs on your Fabric client. So there we go, everything is there. Head back to your launcher page and make sure Fabric is selected. Hit play, and this is going to install. Now, what I've noticed is with the Iris mod installed, your launcher does start up a little bit slower, and that is because it does give you additional options to have shaders, and there are more options visually, video settings wise, to boost the performance of your Minecraft experience. So it is going to take a little bit longer. I'm not going to go ahead and skip ahead anything. You guys can kind of time the difference between how fast my 1.19 had loaded in the past and how kind of slowish, you know, my experience that it's loading up right now. And that's just because it has some stuff in the background that is just loading a little bit slower than the past. And I can obviously tell it's quite a bit slower for me. So I'm gonna go ahead and reposition my little window here back up where you guys can all see the frame rates and everything can be seen easy peasy. That did not work there. Let's go ahead and redo that. That should be good. Let me make sure, yep, right there. I wanna make sure you guys can see my screen 100% there. Okay, we're using the Fabric modded client. We're going to go back into the exact same server, Unchallenged.Ga. This is our completely public SMP. We have two servers in there. We have our 100% survival server. You could die as much as you'd like, come back without any sort of issues. There's 14 worlds total to explore. There's ranks, there's kits, there's bosses. There's extra bosses throughout the worlds. There's mobs that are different all around the world. There's legendary items and dungeons all located around the world and stuff. And then we have our hardcore survival server, which is located over that way. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and jump into our survival server to redo the experience that we previously kind of showcased. Right now I'm running about 113 to about 140 frames per second. If we begin to kind of fly around and check out some different areas of the world, I do feel like it's a little bit brighter than it was prior without the Iris mod installed. And as we're kind of flying around here, we're still seeing lots of clouds. We're still seeing lots of trees. There's some chunk generation being done at the moment. So if it's kind of pausing a little bit, that's because we're flying so fast and we're traveling that some of the chunks here in this world haven't been fully explored. But let's go ahead and now, because we've downloaded the Iris installer, the mod, if we go into our options and go into our video settings, we now have the shader pack option here. Now, shaders can be enabled or disabled in this option. And in my case, I want to have them enabled. Complementary shaders is what I recommend and use 100% of the time. And I'm going to go ahead and apply that because it makes the Minecraft experience just so much better here. And I'm running in the potato mode right now because, you know, I actually don't mind the potato mode. And I'll show you the differences here. A lot of it just lighting and water. But yeah, you can see some of the shadows here. You know what? I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to still keep a little bit kind of checking out a little bit here. But we're going to be going back down to the overworld because this world really hasn't been explored a whole lot. And it's just kind of adding some extra stuff that otherwise wouldn't be there. I'm still hitting about 100 frames per second, 90 to 105 frames per second, while this shader pack is enabled with Sodium. So that is actually really nice here. Check out the whole visual experience here of the land. I think this is the snow, like the packed snow that's up there. I think I can probably fly through it. Yeah, I can fly through this stuff. Whoop, it's kind of laggish. Just because a lot of this hasn't been loaded in. But if we go down to the overworld, let's go ahead and fly down and drop. And I'm going to do a slash home and go slash home. There we go. Okay, so now that we're home, all the chunks here in our home area have been sort of created already. So we shouldn't see a lot of that lag as the chunks are building. But you can clearly see here we have shaders loaded up. The sky biome looks very nice. The skybox. We also have the farm that didn't have shaders in the past. We can see the water here looks very nicely. And this is all on 1.19 right now. So let's go ahead and pull up our frames per second. So while we were in the previous earlier sessions, while we were loading vanilla client. We around this area here, we were getting between 40 to 60 frames per second. And right now we're running shaders, we're running resource packs, we're flying around these heavily densed areas in our barn area. And in the barn, we're running about 60 frames per second, which initially in our vanilla client, we were getting between 40 to 60 frames per second in this area. Now we're getting around 50 to 80 frames per second while using shaders, while having the same default settings. We're actually basically getting double our frames per second while running shaders in this pack. And if we fly over the ocean here with shaders on still, we're still getting about that 110 frames per second as we move further out. Seems about there, like 90 to about 110 frames per second. Seems pretty nice, but this is with shader packs. And that's what we had on our frames per second without shader pack using the vanilla client. So it is really nice there to kind of get the increased performance. Same great stuff. I ran into the wall. That hurt. So yeah, that is the whole installation process of how to go from step one, installing Fabric, step two, basically doubling your frame rates with sodium, to step three, how to play Minecraft 1.19 with shaders. And again, complimentary is the shader pack that I'm kind of using right now. And the big difference here between Potato and the other setting here, let's go back to shaders, shader pack resources, and we're gonna turn this thing on high. This is the default setting. You'll notice that the light, the water will be a lot different now. So let's go ahead and check out the barn. We'll see some big reflective differences, the shadows on the buildings. You can see a lot of the shadows from the mountainside. My shadow here as well. As the sun goes down right now, I don't know where the sun's at. It's overhead, so it's about noon in the day cycle. But as it begins to set on the west, we'll notice the directional of the sunlight kind of begin to hit differently. That's all good. Okay. I just want to kind of verify some of the settings there. But yeah, we can see some of the shadows here from the buildings, kind of casting the shadows over. So that is going to be it from me in this video. I appreciate everyone that has tuned in. Again, if you guys have any comments or questions for me, let me know down in the comment section below. Right now, we're running shaders on 1.19. with the use of the Fabric client, Sodium, and the Iris installer mod. So it looks very nice this way, very visual. So if you guys are enjoying this content, if this is something that you haven't seen anywhere else before, I would appreciate if you guys go down below, hit the red button to subscribe, make it gray, hit the bell to be notified every time we release a brand new video. And of course, give this video a thumbs up, make it blue. There, I saw something over there. I saw a building. Oh, somebody built something over here. It looks very nice. Okay, but that is going to be it from me, you guys. I appreciate everyone tuning in today, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.